Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're striper fishing on the Feather River in California, and then kayak fishing for cutthroat trout on Lake Sammamish in Washington. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. We're on the Feather River at Yuba City, where late winter storms have forced large releases from upriver reservoirs. The high water brings the fish, but it also gives us challenging conditions. We're with Wraith Hereford and Ryan Tripp of RH Guide Service, who tried a little trolling early to begin with, but quickly changed programs.
We tried some trolling, but I got a little hot spot here that we like to cast, and so we're gonna slowly cast worms out. We're gonna let them hit the bottom. We're gonna reel them back. The water's real high and dark like this. Get some worms, put them on, let them hit the bottom. For stripers, they have a hard time not hitting them. So if there's any fish in the area, we'll know here in a little bit. Hey, hey, hey.
All right, here on the Feather River, you can only keep stripers that are up to 18 inches, and this is one that's pushing the limit. We could keep this one if we were keeping them, but we're gonna chuck them back today. I just put a little swipe of this new Procure wax on. Second cast out there, got that nice fish right there. Go put a little bit more on, go back to casting. Another one on the worm. Nice keeper. On the black worm.
What's going on here today is the Department of Water Resources is real scared about all the rain we're getting. We just put millions and millions of dollars in our spillway system, and they're trying to get the water out of the lake now. We're supposed to have a real hot rain come in. And yesterday, the water's come up 10 feet since yesterday. As you can see, there's foam and there's trees floating down the river and that. But we know there's a lot of fish here. So everybody's changing rivers and they're all worried. And a lot of people aren't coming out today because of the conditions. But the water's clean. It's coming out of the lake. It's just coming off all sides of the bank. And it's not like crystal clear water because it's washing the bank away. But so it's making the conditions very tough. And with the right presentation in the right spot with the right equipment, you're gonna be successful in fishing today. So we've already Ryan's caught two fish already, and we just started. So slow it down, slow your fishing down, and you're gonna catch fish. They're here. You just gotta slow down, get in the right spot, put it in the right place, right time, and you're gonna get a fish.
We're fishing these black worms today because the water's a little dirty and this black color really silhouettes in this water and grabs their attention. And they also bite these because there's eel running up the river this time of year, and the stripers love to eat those eel. So that's why we're fishing these black worms. And they've been biting them pretty good today.
We got a black worm. You're going to go just past the barb. Then you bring it all the way out up to the bend and turn it. I like to go just over the tip of the hook, right at the knot. You're going to bend it a little, bam, like that. Ryan's been catching all the fish on the worm, so I'm going to the worm. I took over the black worm, so I don't know why they're hitting it. I think it's because of the color of the water. They love the eel too, also, that come up this time of year, but the color of the water is definitely a little stained, so we'll see. The black worm seems to be the ticket.
This one's slammed. Another nice keeper. Mm-hmm. Still biting the black worm.
A We normally use Procure sardine is what's been working on ours, our anchovy gel. And I forgot, I'm not in my boat. So we have this minnow blend wax, bait wax by Procure. It's the new stuff. I've never used it. I'm gonna put it on right now. There's some fish here. So if I can just get a little more of a bite, I'm getting little taps. And normally when that happens, I put on my Procure different oils and gels. I use both, but this is the wax. I'm gonna try, it's a minnow blend, and I'm gonna rub it all over my worm. Never use it, this the first time, so I'm just gonna rub her all over the worm. Yeah, it's got a different smell to it, so that's it. I'm gonna put that on, and I think from what happens on the other Procures I use, I get a better bite. I mean, it goes from a little tap to they grab it harder, enough so I can get a hook set and catch the fish, so we'll see what happens.
For this week's fishing, we recommend the Cousins GTS 79M-1SG spinning rod, the Daiwa Ballistic 2500 spinning reel, P-Line 50-pound XTCB braid and 20-pound CXX leader, and Procure Minnow Bait Wax or Sardine Super Gel. Today we're on the Feather River fishing for stripers, mainly with black plastic worms, but the black plastic worm is definitely not your only option for striper fishing. These are Acme Tackle Little Cleos. Now on the West Coast, they're probably better known as a high quality steelhead spoon, but really they're just a high quality spoon that represents a dying bait fish, so any predatory fish is likely to hit them. I had taken a few of these with me on this trip and showed him the Wraith. He wanted to give him a try, and now he's a believer in the Little Cleo, as you're about to find out. And I think these could be a whole lot better option than spending up to $1.50 each for live minnows. Now let's go back and do some more fishing.
For this episode, I had hoped to film on the Yuba River as well, using the new Angler West Edition Magnum Power Drifter. Normally the Yuba is well suited for this type of boat, but today the high water level made it unfishable. The small tributaries offer some great fishing that maybe you haven't seen before, and hopefully we'll be able to show you some of these in the future. But for today, we'll focus on the main river.
Brian's—he's getting me on the worm. I'm not catching anything on the worm, and he's caught three fish already. So, and getting a lot of bites. But I know they're not the biggest fish in the world out there, but they're real aggressive. They're stripers. They're eating minnows. So we're gonna try this. It's got a nice shape to it. It's gonna create a lot of movement in the water, erratic. So they're gonna think it's a dying minnow, and that's—I think I can get bit on it. I think these fish will bite. Like this lure, it's a perfect spooning lure, also vertical. So we're going to try it casting. We know there's fish right here. Catch them on flies here, swim baits, worms. We'll try the Cleo, see what happens. Yeah! Look at that, Little Cleo. We knew they were hitting minnows, and we had some Little Cleos, and we put them on and letting it flutter down. They catch everything. It's a pink and gold one. Look at him. That fish choked down his throat. Look at, it's all the way down his throat. He's not hurt, so I can get him out and let him go, but Little Cleo, unreal. I mean, that little spoon. We knew the stripers would tear them up, but you can jig them and twitch them. We're gonna let him go right here. Yeah, we're in muddy water, and I mean it's semi-clear, but you know it's got vibration, it's got flash. I mean we thought it would work, and it's working. And you could also go by the trees and twitch them. I mean, it'd be a really good spooning lure, straight up and down vertical spooning. Or like we're doing, we know there's fish out there. We're casting, we're letting it fall, and it happened. Boom! That was, you know, that's the first 10 casts on it, and he just caught a fish. I've been throwing swim baits and all that. So, you know, when you're thinking of striper, there's a lot of other options out there. Anything that could mimic a dying minnow, and there you go, right there. That thing was awesome.
That's a better one. Oh yeah.
He's coming through the grass. Chatterbait. Nice.
Nice bass.
On that Procure wax. Letting it fall, I was letting that worm fall all the way to the bottom, and just as it touched the bottom, pow. Another nice keeper. I always just want to grab them by the bottom lip because they got real sharp. Got a real sharp ball of teeth there. You just grab them by that bottom lip and hold them. Pop them out and you're good to go. Just another keeper bass. Yeah, he's hooked in that bottom jaw front. You gotta be real careful because they'll cut the heck out of you. It's a funny bite. We don't like it when they're biting like that. It should come out the top of the nose. These fish, when they're biting right, I don't know, when you hook them in the bottom, he barely just barely felt something on there, but then it went out the bottom of the jaw. I don't know what causes that, but normally you get them all through the top of the nose or out the corner, but that bottom jaw deal, I don't know what the deal is with that, but it's a funny thing. So, nope, I got my worm on now, so Brian's in trouble up there. I'm gonna come back.
Lake Sammamish is one of many Northwest lakes well-suited for kayak fishing. Today, we're with Max Lure Pro Staff member, Brad Hull.
We're on Lake Sammamish, right outside of Seattle in the town of Issaquah. We're gonna be trolling for cutthroat trout via kayak.
Using a wiggle hoochie made by Max Lure. And we're gonna tip this with a little scent or a little worm, try to get these cutthroat trout to bite. What I'm using here too is a lead core line. It's an 18 pound lead core that's spooled on here, and I've got about 40 to 50 pound of 12 pound mono as a leader on here. Pretty easy setup. The lead core allows you to get down about 6 feet in the water column every color at a trolling speed of 1.5 to 2 miles per hour out here in the lake. We're probably gonna be dropping down at least 2 to 3 colors, or 12 to 15 feet to target these fish.
Okay, I've got this sweet shrimp bait wax by Procure. I'm gonna dab a little bit of this on the wiggle hoochie itself just to give it a little extra scent. It seems to be hard and sticky. It's not like a gel or whatnot, so it's easy to use. It doesn't get all over the place. So I'm just gonna rub a little bit on the skirt of this wiggle hoochie, but also on the hook here. Also gonna put a little natural worm here that I'm just going to cut in half. These are just a small ground worm. I'm going to tip each hook with that. I use a small worm so it doesn't affect the action of the lure too much. A bigger night crawler might give it a different presentation. So Lake Sammamish actually connects to Lake Washington via slough. There's actually a salmon hatchery right up in town here. This lake sees a lot of salmon from sockeye to kings to coho that come back, that return to the hatchery. But also in here are a variety of other fish, from bass to perch and these cutthroat trout, which we're targeting. Now, state biologists would like to see the numbers of cutthroat trout reduced in here because they are a predatory fish and they do feed on quite a few salmon smolt. These fish can get pretty large. We got one last week that was 4 or 5 pounds. There are bigger fish in the lake. Some of these fish actually go out to the Puget Sound, feed, and come back here to spawn. Other ones are native to the lake, both Lake Washington and Lake Sammamish. Again, you're allowed to keep 5 cutthroat trout per day. They're pretty delicious fish if you've never eaten cutthroat trout. They're because they're feeding on salmon smolt and fish and bugs. They are an oily meat, like a salmon, but delicious smoked or thrown right on the barbecue. Okay, so I'm letting this lead core line out. I'm letting it out pulling out a color at a time. I'm pulling out the mono first. I like to pull this out by hand until it gets to the lead core, which will give you a little weight and help it easily deploy in the water column. So I'm gonna pull this line out. Like I said, it's about 40 to 50 feet until I get to my first color. I'm gonna let out 2 to 3 colors. I'm going about 1.5 to 1.75 mile per hour, give or take. What I like to do also is slow my speed down and then speed up a little bit. And that just sometimes gets the fish to attack the bait. With these kayaks too, you can slow your speed down and increase pretty easy. I also like to incorporate a couple S turns, and that changes the flow of the bait through the water column, dropping and falling, which sometimes can trigger a strike. Again, we're marking quite a few fish in the fish finder here. Lots of arcs, lots of bait. There's also quite a few schools of perch in here that you occasionally pick up if you're trolling slow enough. So I've been using Max lures out on Sammamish for years now. I tend to use a lot of wiggle hoochies because I think they resemble a wounded bait fish which they're feeding on. We caught some nice sized cutthroat last week out here, and a few of them were coughing up good sized salmon smolts in the lake. But during the winter, and when the bait is a little more scarce, you can find them up top feeding on bugs, rolling at the surface. Even November and December, there's a hatch that goes on the lake, a hatch of midges that bring the fish up close to the surface. And you can troll a lot shallower than, say, the summertime when the water warms up.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed today's episode from Lake Sammamish, where we're doing a little kayak fishing using wiggle hoochies. Now, before we go back, I want to show you a setup that I was using the other day on a little trout lake that you might try yourself. Well, wiggle hoochies have a lot of action on their own, so you don't necessarily need to run them behind a dodger. On this one, I've got about an 18 or 20 inch leader to an Oregon tackle scent chamber. On top of that scent chamber, I've got a small bullet weight, just enough to get it down for this particular lake that we were in, and a couple of beads for my smile blade to run on. Now, when that smile blade's turning on there, it adds a lot of color and flash and action to your scent chamber, turning it into an attractor. I've had a lot of great success with this setup over the years. Now, inside the scent chamber, I was running the original formula scent chamber magic, which is made with krill, something that trout really like. A question that I get quite a bit is, how do you clean the scent chambers? Well, it's very simple. You just take your fingers and pop that bead out. Then a little bit of soap. Hot water is best, but even this lake water works fine. And what I like to use is the Badass Hand and Lure Soap from Procure. Really does a great job. Now, let's go back to Lake Sammamish and do some more kayak fishing.
We're targeting cutthroat trout using a kayak, a highly effective tool when used correctly.
When I see a strike, I'll often give a couple swift pedals of the kayak to get it moving faster, and that sometimes helps set the hook. What's great about Max lures is, you know, they don't require a lot of a fast speed to troll them. Some of their smile blades, and wedding ring spinners and wiggle hoochies, you can troll under a half mile an hour and get a nice presentation on them. So in a kayak, that can be essential because you're often at times not going the same speed as a boat. Oh, here's a fish. That lead core, your line's quite a ways out there, so it takes a little bit for the fish to come in. What we have here is a cutthroat trout. Lake Sammamish. It grabbed this wiggle hoochie that was tipped with a worm. I find the chartreuse or orange wiggle hoochie work best in this lake, but you can also use Max Lure wedding rings in chartreuse or orange as well. These are really healthy fish. I mean, much hardier than, say, a rainbow trout. So we're going to let this fish go. You are allowed to keep 5 cutthroat trout on the lake per day, per angler, but we're going to let this one swim another day. Nice, pretty fish. Some of these fish actually go out to the Puget Sound to feed and then come back here to spawn, so there we go. So we've got this chartreuse colored wiggle hoochie here. Comes in the packet with 2 red hooks and these great UV bills now. You can see a little purple essence here, but down in the water column this will really glow and help attract fish. What's nice now is Max actually sells these bills, so you can make your own wiggle hoochies or even use this on a wedding ring. Gives it some nice flutter action. This is moving back and forth in the water. It's dropping with that lead core. Symbolizes a hoochie squid or a wounded bait fish. I like this yellow color. It always seems to produce well on this lake, the chartreuse yellow, but it's also available in orange and purple and a variety of different colors. So try a different color and see if it works for you. So if you've never fished from a kayak before, the technology and the evolution has changed quite a bit the past few years. You're now seeing a lot of kayaks becoming more wider, sit on top like this one, comfy seats where you don't have a wet butt after a day of being on the water. You're getting more and more people that are selling their boats and getting into a smaller watercraft because for exercise or cost or just a different way to target a fish. But if you haven't been in a fishing kayak, get out there and try a few models. I prefer these. This is a Hobie. It's a pedal-powered kayak, but there are several models on the market today that are both paddle and pedal options for propulsion. But definitely a fun way to target fish.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.